Good morning. I just have to find. Oh no, not there. Gosh. There we are. I have to turn the sound off. Like that. Hi, Sargat. Good morning. Yes, I know it's early, but I suddenly had a chance to jump on. And I'll be on probably only about an hour. I don't know how long Hapster and the youngest one is gone. Hi, Cassie. Good to see you. And my daughter is home and she is in the shower, so she might occur too. But that's okay. We'll just have to deal with that. At least two of us are out, so I actually can do some coloring. I think we're gonna do some leaves and stuff. Yeah, sure, it's hard got. Just do what you have to do. I'm all okay. I will manage. Cassie is here. I have to find some flowers. I'm just going to color some leaves and stuff. And hi, River. Welcome. Haven't seen you here before. So, how are you all? I hope that you are good. Today I am very good. I had a good night sleep and I got up early and have been up and on for some hours now. Yeah. Good morning, Italy. Welcome, River. So it's quite early for half the world yet, but I thought that I'll just get on when I could anyways. Just to get some more of this done, because it will be in a lot of parts. And my plans for today is more or less just one thing, and that is to make some dinner. From that, I'll just color. Or as a mom, there will be all the things, and I got the dogs and the cats too, so. Yeah, you are a hard shifter. Oh, that's early, River. at me now, it is 12:26 p.m. Actually, so it's not that early for me. So, Cassie, how was your night shift? Hope it was good then. Not that much to do. Yeah. I have had that too, Teddy. And I often are awake at odd times, and then it's actually good having YouTube because somewhere it's 5 o'clock, and there is always someone's up somewhere in the world. Oh, that's good, Cassie. You're off for all to Sunday night. Yeah, you. That's good. And if some of you hear some weird sounds now, it's because I got my little pup right next to me. So she might start snoring or whatever she's doing. I think that part is a piece of my flower that should be like that one. So I have to put that in later on. Another total garden. Yeah. I hope you get at least some sleep. I used to work nights too, but after some years I just couldn't do it. Or I loved it, but my body didn't. So I had to stop that, actually. But I had a bar for several years. I was at that bar for, I think it was 9 years. So then I was working there evening and nights, and came home and got some hours sleep and had to get up with kids and stuff. And when they went for school, I had a little nap and did dinner, ate up all the kids and went to work. And like that for several years. I just have to put in that flower there. Yeah, Cassie, your body might tell you when it's enough. Base. One day it will say, nope, this ain't working anymore. Oh, it was. Terry, I loved it. I'm educated as an accountant, and that work was really serious, and you don't mess around with other people's money or numbers. So, and I was a girl and I was young, newly educated, so I had a pretty hard tough in this environment where I worked with only or mostly old males. And my last office actually was had most females. But anyway, it was a really serious kind of a job. So, and I'm more into having fun and flirt and fool around. Just having fun. So I figured out that I needed a hobby. So a friend of mine called me one day and asked me if we should open a bar just nearby, and my first reaction was like, oh my god, are you mad? I can't. I got my work and kids and all, and I just haven't got the time. And she said that she would run the bar if I just did all the paperwork. So I thought about it, and I said, oh, okay. So I got the money, and we bought the bar. And of course, I didn't just want to be outside of it. So I worked there, too, more and more and more, and I loved it. It was so much fun. It's so much fun arranging parties and here listening to other people's stories. And I never knew just how much it meant for others just to listen. But I did, and I experienced so much. And I loved it. I actually loved those quiet Sundays, the mostly with the old the drunks. A lot more than the busy Saturday nights, because they all had so many stories to tell, and they was just so sweet. And of course, it's good to tell them to go home when they are the drunken or nauseous or not behaving well. So that was awesome too. So actually that job was actually one of my best jobs ever, just because I got so close to so many people. So many of my guests was more like friends actually than guests, and they all had their reasons for coming. This is a butter. Yes, I have bought in this. This is the Faber Castell. Thank you, Hargot. I'm using the Inktense. Yes, it is watercolor pencils, except that these are inks when or they turn into inks when they are being wet and they die fully. So they, you put them on like regular water color and pencils, but when you wet them and they die, you can't move them anymore. So they are permanent. Hi, Kenneth. Hi. Good morning. You're up early. So yes, I am watercoloring, or sort of, because these turn into ink, really. And I find them very good on this grayscale images. They cover so good. And this is actually quite dark. Gray is scale too. Good morning, Andrea. Yeah, Cassie, well, you should. The ink tents are fun to work with, and you kind of have to use them to get to know them. And I think they are very much fun. They are quite easy to use as long as you don't put on too much pigment, because then you really easy make mud. But you'll also get the feel for how much pigment you actually need then when you use them more and more. And I think that the ink tents actually are a very overlooked medium. I see that many have them, but they don't use them, and that's a pity. Because why have something that you never use? How I am, Kenneth? I'm very good. I had a good night and sleep. I got up and took my son to work. And been up and about for some hours now, actually. And then my hubby took the youngest one out on bike riding. So then it's just me and my daughter at home. And then I was like, oh my god, I can do daddy. Hi, Kenny. Welcome. Well, go to bed, Kenny, darling. Oh my god. 30:40. That's late. And now, because the most paper will wrinkle it. That's just how it is. And if you really hate it, you can iron it. Just take some baking paper over your page when it's done and iron it flat. I know some does that. I don't really mind any buckling or crinkling. I love the sound of it, and as long as a page isn't ruined, like a hole in it or like that, then it's all okay by me. Hi, Susan. Good morning. And Julie, too. Welcome, you both. And Cassie, if you find that it wrinkles a lot, you can... well, you can't avoid it, really. It's quite hard to totally avoid it. Just flatten it down and put it in between books and flatten it or iron it or... Well, Susan, then you have come to the right channel because I'm doing this whole picture in only Inktense, or not only, but mostly Inktense. So you might pick up some tips here so you actually can use yours more. First rule is really to or not to color the whole picture. Just leave some areas uncolored because the pigment will go so far when you wet it. Like now, I have colored more or less the inside and the outside, and then I take the water brush and start wetting it from the uncolored areas that will be the highlighted areas, and working my way out to the pigment. Then I can also pull it like down if I want more of it. I can zoom a little bit closer on the next one, so you actually get to see close up what I'm doing. Yeah, Kenny, have a good night, sleep well, and I'll see you some other day. Thank you, Julie. Let me see if I can... Oh, zoom in. My God. Let me see. Where did... is my leaf? Gosh. Closing in too much. There it is. Now, you see, I have colored with light green in the inside there and inside there. And... mixed it, or I got the darkest green on the outside and in the middle vein. Hi Carla, welcome. Good morning. So I don't color the whole leaf. I color just like the inner part and the outer part, and leaving some parts uncolored. So I get highlights. Good morning, Kim. And when I start wetting it, I go from the uncolored area and working my way up to the color. Then I can pull it down, and so I get color where I want it. That. From the lightest area, wetting it. Yep. Same over here. From the uncolored area, working my way out. Starting in the uncolored, working my way in, pulling the pigment up in that area. Around the edges, I wet it to. Working the pigments to where I want it. And I mostly want it on the outer edges and on the inside edges. And that's where I got this highlights too. Mm-hmm. So a little too little. We are so close that this actually look. I'll try to zoom a little bit out. Come on. Can I use this one? No. That. This is the leaf. Oh my god. That was my daughter getting some ice and she dug up the whole box. Oh, Susan, you can't see your questions. That's weird because I can see them, Susan. Thank you, Kim. Hi, Lizzie. Welcome. So we have some more leaves, like over there. My daughter is 20 now. And she is going to study at the university in a town called Bode, which is so far from me. So we will take her up there next week. So then I'll be gone for some days. I think I need to sharpen my pencil a little bit. No, Susan, I sometimes take the color from the tip of my pencil, and it depends on what I want. When I want to add more shadows to something, I take the color from the pencil tip and apply it with the water brush. I can sometimes even scribble out some color on paper and mix them like on the paper and add some water and pick it up from there. It all depends on what I want. Now mixing on the paper can be very good and very easy and fast thing to do, but for example, like with skin, you really don't see the color before you add the water. And then I like to mix that on a palette next to me. Yes, I am Terry, very, and this girl, she is doing, and have all the base done really good at school. She's all the base been very school smart, and she loves to learn. And even if she is going away very far off, I know she'll do just fine. We have raised her well, and she is very wise for her age. She doesn't party a lot, maybe once a month. At the max, since he has had a job for a year, made her own money, and she doesn't spend it on just nonsense. So I am very proud of her. Then I have a son too with Asperger, which is a form for autism. He is 22. Now he's never really liked school, so he has educated himself into. I don't know the English word for it, but he like those who build houses out of lumber. And just now he is testing out this new job at this warehouse that sells lumbers and stuff for your house. Hi, Elizabeth. Good morning. And if I'm covering up a lot of the page, I am sorry. And this new job, it looks like he likes it. It is summer, of course, so many of the bosses are on holiday, so he finds it a little bit hard because there is not that many that are in charge right now. But he managed. I think that is enough of pigment down. No, I just need a sip of my coffee. Oh, that one was cold. Yeah, thank you, Cassie. Yes, it is, Lizzie. She finally went to sleep now. That is my Aria, which is a French bulldog. She's now, or this month, she's turning 11 months old. So yes, that is my dog. That is snoring. I have this big desk and they and it that spot that usually are for the printer, I think it's kind of above the main desk and up there my dogs loves to sit and look out the window and they sleep there and so I'm going, I'm starting in the colored area, vetting that and working my way into the colors and pushes the pigment to where I want it. And I'm wetting this darkest in the inner parts too. Pulling that out as well. Like that. So, do we have any more? We have those small leaves up behind there. I think maybe we'll find a really dark green color. Just add some colors in there. Now these won't be showing that well, so I won't do them very detailed, just getting some color on them. And this one behind there. Come on. Oh, it is wet. Oh my god, I'm going outside the lines. Well, I just have to be okay. Pulling something down. Like that. So. Done with some leaves for now. Might have to do more later on because there always pops up some leaves that I haven't done. Let me see if I end like that. Well, what about having a cup of coffee first and then see if you can sleep after a bit? Unless you are one of those that actually can't sleep with on a coffee, I mean. Sure, Susan. We can do this one. Or do you mean a line art picture? Whoa. Oh my god. Come on. Ugh. I don't know what kind of animal this animal actually is, but it. But that's all okay. We can color him now with the Inktense. Yeah, Cassie, that's good. Well, then I would have had a cup of coffee first and just till the little bit and then we'll go on to bed afterwards. Let's see, baked earth might be a good color for this little animal thingy that I don't really know what is, but I'll make him mine anyways. I want something that is a little bit darker too, but just not that much. Maybe we can try some of this bark, but that is actually a quite dark brown color. And might need something little lighter yellow thing too. We have several, actually. We can have, what is this called? What's this? This is tan. Yeah. Yeah, it looks kind of like a chinchilla. Except that they usually are more fluffy, aren't they? I think it looks more like a, what do you call them, a digus. I don't know the English word for it, but anyways, it's an animal, and I'll color it. I don't have to know what things are to uncolor them. I just color them anyway like I wanted, so I'm adding a little bit of this darkest one, this bark color, into the darkest areas, those shaded areas. Maybe we'll add a little bit down here on this tail part. It's a funny looking animal, but. And we will, and I will add this lightest color in this highlighted areas now on a scale picture. You already have the highlights and shadowed areas, so you can actually just fill in what you want. And I will add some of this lighter in the rocks, like here and there. Oh my god, Aria. Thank you, Susan. You are too nice. Well, but you are right that it doesn't matter what kind of animal this is. We'll just color him anyway. Or her. I don't know if it's a he or a she. And here too, I'm taking, or I'm coloring more or less only the outlines of this little animal. Like you see, I don't color every bit. And I will add just some stripes here and there. Just to get a little bit more pigment, but not much, because this darker pigment will take over the lighter one. And here I'm going in with the lighter again. Now we will add a little bit more of this yellowy, or this tan color, wasn't it tan, it was called, yeah, it was tan. And if we need more, oh, I'm sorry, later, then we'll just add more. Out of town, Robin. Okay, have a wonderful day. I hope it all goes well. Then I start wetting the lightest areas again, because so I can keep them more or less light still. So I've wetted the ears. I can wet this nose area too, just pulling that out. Then I need a little bit more water. I'm going and activating all these other parts here. I'm also going that way that the fur grows. Like, I don't mix them in like this, because this one goes like that. So then I also move my brush that way that the fur grows. I need to pull some more of that dark down there. Now his little feet. This one we actually didn't color, so we had to get some of this tan color. That. I might need some color under there. We can bring those whiskers out later on. So now again I'm wetting a little bit in the middle. This. Then I'm moving my way out to the outer section, all as I also do it the way that the fur grows. Now I'm pulled with me some of this dark color, so I'm just wiping my brush off. Then I'm wetting the darkest color, this bark color, pulling that out. Now that little part there more or less almost disappeared. But we will add some of this tan color. Hi, Peran says, good morning. Thank you. So again, working my way from the lightest area and wetting it up to the darker one. Now if I did this the other way, I would pull the dark color all the way over the light color, so the light color actually wouldn't show. And I might also make mud. So now I'm taking my color pad on the tip and adding it on, as this is a very small area. Now this animal is actually quite small all in all. I'm zoomed very close in. So I also want a little bit of pink on his nose. Let me see where is it, like there. Oh my god, that was too much pigment. But like that. Maybe a little pink on his feet. Just adding a little bit and pulling that out. So that was the first layer. So now if I want to intensify the colors, I can just wait until he's dry and do the whole thing again. You also see that I have this line down here that I really don't like that much. Hi, Alyssa. Welcome. So, and some more of this tan color, which was my lightest color. And stripes, or stripples, or what do you call them? Then I will. Might need a little more of a point on this one. I have a sharp point, putting some lines in here. My paper is still a little bit too wet, actually, for this pencil, but that will just have to be anyways. So I'm just activating it slowly, working my way down. I do need some more yellow on this, some tan color on this ear too. Now around this way, working my way up. Then I'm just activating this feet. Oh, Princess Canada, that sounds exciting. I hope you get that job. So now we got all of this in, and we might need... Yeah, we need to color his little eye. I think I'll just pull a little bit of this medium color and put that in his eye, actually. And I will bring back his highlight later. Yeah, that's a good way of Susan, I've been coloring like in a coloring books now for over 3 years. I have always been painting with something. Morning, Charlotte. Hi. And I started watercoloring when I was 16. Then I discovered boys and work and life. So I kind of put that on the shelf for some time. And then I started with acrylic painting and some oil painting. Like now and then, so I've kind of always been doing something. But coloring, I really like this. I've been doing now for a little over 3 years. Now I'm taking this white gel pen just to add back some small highlights in this fur. So I'm dabbing it on and just wiping it off. I do have a university education, but that is in other stuff. It's not art. In Norway, it's not really that common to have plain art schools. And I probably wouldn't have taken those anyways, because I have to make money, and working as an artist in Norway can be really, really hard. So I kind of never done that. But it would be fun though to actually take a course or something, because I'm totally self-taught, or taught by YouTube. Hi, Melody. Good morning. With a cup of Joe. Is that coffee, Kim? So now I've gotten some of this back, and then I'm taking this light color again and just pushing this white a little bit back, because I don't want it to be really white. I just want them to be a little bit lighter than the rest, really, like that. So it is highlighted, just not plain white. Oh, have a nice day, Kenneth, and we'll see you some other day. Now, if I zoom out from this little fellow, try to, like, oh my god, no, come on, out. Okay, like that. Okay. Katrina, hi, welcome. Good morning. Oh, and we might need a little highlight. I told you I was getting it back in his eyes. A little bit, come on. Like that. We might work on him some more later. Hi, Joy. Good morning. So, that was him. So we have gotten quite far. Now I don't know what all of that this stuff at the back here are, but I think that that's actually okay, because we don't need to. We can just color it anyways. Thank you, Charlotte. It's peas. Yeah, it looks like peas. But it's not really the pea fruit or to it. Thank you, Elizabeth. You are so sweet. What color do you, I think we should do this part then. I actually think that it should be some more pinks in this, because for now we more or less only have these flowers with pinks in it. We have purples and blues, and blue and purple, and blue and purple. So I think, yeah, get your coffee, Charlotte. How did I make this butterfly so sparkly? Well, it's my magic. Ooh, 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 ooh. If you want to know how, then I did this butterfly. I think it was in episode 2. It's a technique that where I make the illusion of glitter. So it's an illusion of sparkle. And it actually does sparkle too when I use gel pens with glitter in it. Or you can add some, like we did on this one, we put some pink of Stella on top of it after we were done. If you can see it, start turning a little bit. Oh my God, Charlotte, have you lost your coffee cup? That's really bad. I think I have to send you one. Yeah, maybe they are beads and ribbons down here. Well, Susan, how I put my colors together is something many ask me all the time, and I thought that I would just show everybody my whole process. So I'm doing this picture from the start to end on camera, so you actually get to see how I choose my colors and how I do all that I do. So later on I won't be doing a full picture like this, because this takes a lot of time and are a lot of parts. So but this one I wanted to make one fully with you guys, so you can see. If there is a rule of thumb on putting a color palette together, well, not really, because you can put more or less anything together. As long as you know what you are doing, because some colors will lift other colors, and some colors will actually dull some colors, and some colors, like if you put blue behind like yellow, it will actually kind of promote that yellow even more. So there are a lot of color theory that you can study, which really is an education all on its own. But I usually tell people, look at nature, look what's going together. You will see that green and blue goes together with almost anything, no matter what. And then you just pick up those colors you like and that you think looks good together. And if you aren't sure, then check on nature. And to see if there actually are flowers that has these colors in them. No, no, Susan, don't stop. Oh gosh, no. Keep on asking me questions. I like that. For example, somebody told me, can I really put yellow next to green? And I said, only as long as you have seen Easter lilies. And what I meant is that Easter lilies are yellow, and their leaves and stem is green. So of course you can use them. Now the rule of three, Kim. I have another video about that. That is also actually a quite a big topic, but I try to make it easy. You can use it like in theory or in many ways, but what I use that for is to pick up three shades of one color. Melody, I don't know yet, because my youngest one isn't at school yet, and I don't know his schedule yet. But as it looks for poor now, then yeah, maybe. I don't really know for sure. But the rule of theory is that you always should take three shades of the same color and color with the for example, if you take yellows, take a light yellow, almost cream color yellow, and a yellow, and then a darker one, or orangey yellow. And for a skin, dark brown, a medium, like a peach color, which is a light brown, and something really light, for example, cream color, that is actually quite bad on yellowish too. Yes, Francis, we have something. Hi, Darlene. Welcome. The teens, when they finish what we call videregående, which is the high school, celebrate that actually in 17 days from the May 1st all the way until May 17th. That is our national day. We call them Russ. So yes, they do party, and they do big parties and party for 17 days actually. So yeah, they do party. The rule of theory also goes or goes with anything really, from fur to skin, clothes, flowers, whatever. And I usually do that, except when this with Inktense. I think that two colors usually is enough, but like I did on this mouse, I'll call it that mouse, I did use three colors. I had this dark bark and this medium baked earth, and we used the tan as the lightest colors. So I used the rule of three on that one. Yeah, princess. Norway are well known for our national day too, which is May the 17th. We not only have this young ones partying and having fun, but we also are among those few countries in the world that actually have children parades. We don't have military parades, but our school children will walk in parade from early morning until quite, or like in Oslo, our capital city, and the schools there walks actually for hours and hours and hours, poor kids. Oh, thank you, Melle Teddy. And everybody should really visit Norton or way to actually see how we do it, because it's quite special actually that we have a children's parade with Russen, music and all, yeah. That's so fun. And again, as I always do with the Inktense, I'll go from the lightest area, working my way into the darker areas. I need to zoom in a little bit, maybe. Yeah, we do Charlotte. It's called a bunad, and it's so nice. I'm actually gotten too fat for mine. I got mine when I was 15 and was confirmed. I don't know the English word for it, but when we go over from being children to adults, we are getting confirmed. Can that be an English word? Yes, Melody, the Inktense Terrible palette is watercolor, so I use that just like regular watercolors. Like for bigger areas and stuff, I need a little bit more water. Thank you. But the Devil pen is just like any watercolor pen set, really. Just pulling some a little bit of pink down. I don't want it to be like really. I think that just want a little bit. Yeah, Charlotte. It's a pity, really. You should get a good picture when you finally got the input to it. I will have to get someone to sew mine out, so I actually can use it, because I love it and I have used mine a lot. I used my bunad for weddings and for baptizing children. I used it for Christmas parties, May 17th, and all kinds of holy days when we have been celebrating other big days, like if someone have 50 years birthday and so on. And I really love mine, it's so pretty. I have a Nordlands bunad, and I reckon you have that too, Charlotte. So we're slowly working our way up. Maybe we will add some pink in this one to this better, and should be brown though. But as we have this pink out, we can just color these things. Now what is what really? Let's see. I believe that is some of that. The back. Oh, well that one is nice too. And I believe that it's the males are supposed to carry knives with that bunad. Hi, Morticia. In a good Brandals bunad. Thank you, Alyssa. Okay, have a good day. And take care. Thank you for coming. Oh, you do, Morticia. Awesome. You have some cheese. That's the traditional one, isn't it, Charlotte? I'll Google it later on, just to see. My mother had just the and that one is so nice too, and I so wanted it, and my mother, she just sold hers, and I was like, oh my god, no, why? I wanted that, and maybe that actually would fit me. Just put a little bit of purple down here so it stands out a little bit. Exactly that one. Now this one is going back down there, so we need to put a little bit of pink down there too. And I think behind this one, this part should be pink too, it looks like. Or that actually might be a leaf or something, but that's okay. I will make it pink. It's my thing now. Yeah. I don't know the difference between those two, but I'll check it out. Graffed direct. I'll have to remember it. Oh, you are addicted to mesost. Mom, that's funny. That's awesome. Have you been to Norway or Tisha? Thank you. Hi, Scooby Girl. And welcome. So if you have been to Norway or Tisha, where did you go? Because it's a fairly big country. So it's not like the in this place, but it's big enough. Welcome back, Sargot. I'm still here, I'm working on this. I'll take this purple and pull it out. I need to clean that tip. We will... Oh. Go in the shade a little bit more and stop later. I'm just pulling some of this color further up. Going in Phantom Delight's area again. Wetting the pigment. And then I can pull it up and take it with me where I want it. Oh, you live in Sweden. I am in Sweden once a month and shopping. Oh, welcome, come back, Chrissy. So, here in Sweden, where you live, like in the south or the north, you are actually quite a long country too. That's like that. Yeah, snus, or I don't buy snus anymore or smoke because we have quit smoking, but I do buy vapor juice with nicotine because in Norway it's not legal to sell this vape juice with nicotine. So I actually have to go to Sweden to get it, and I will have to put Arya on the floor. Come on, Lilleva, come down. Oh. Yeah, or not just food, a lot of stuff is actually cheaper in Sweden for us because Norway is a nice country, but it is also expensive. So to us, more or less any country out there are cheaper than us. So now I'm just putting away some of the rounds that I used in my mouth and taking some other ones out for this dance chair, but I will keep my bark, which is the darkest color. Just add a little bit of that in the shaded area. And a little bit down there. for instance, taxes on fast food. We have taxes on everything. First, when we work and we get paid, we pay taxes on that, which usually is about 32%. I think that was the average, because some pays more and some pays less, like old people pays a lot less, and rich people pays a lot more, but average at 32% goes off our salary. Oh my god, Aria, what are you doing? Find something else and not that noisy bottle. So first we pay that as tax, and then for anything that we buy, we pay a tax called moms, which is 25% of what it costs. That goes on top on that. And we have or that is like if you eat there, if you take the food with you home, like fast food, then it's actually cheaper than to actually eat at the restaurant. But we have a lot of taxes and pay a lot of taxes and what but we also have petty schools, petty hospitals, kindergarten costs, not that much really. There is a small amount we have to pay, but that's not much. And of course, we pay a lot of money to help other countries. You have the same thing. But of course, Norway also have something we call the oil fund. Because of that we have oil, we have this savings that we can use on stuff like extra costs when something happens, or more or less we are using it mostly for helping other countries. We have a sugar tax now too, so that actually has made so that like soft drinks and coke or like coke and candies and stuff actually cost more now. So of course we have to go even oftener or more to Sabiden to buy sugar stuffed sugar stuff. So We even have something that they called palospose avgift. That means that we have to pay a little amount every time we buy a plastic bag. So we buy our also and then have to buy the bag to keep it in to take it with us home if we don't have a bag with us. So every thing costs in or away. So it's an expensive country. Yeah, I use fabric bags. And I actually got this really, really nice one from a parent as a gift with a picture of a French bulldog. And that is just so cute. So how long have I been on now? An hour and a half. That's not bad. Time's gone fast. Maybe we will do some of those bad answers down here too while we have this. Brown color out. Sam also recently asked me how do I start on a picture, and I think I said that in the beginning of this picture. If you are not sure what you want to color, just take or just color the stuff that you know the colors on, like these leaves. Start with them. Or if you know that you want a blue sky, start with that and just add the colors as you go. Thank you, Charlotte. I'm so happy you like it. What? Men hva det det? Skal du opp igjen? I have to lift my little Arya up again. Yeah, wait, hang on. And no, Charlotte, I never heard that. Yes, you did, and that's nice. I haven't tried them yet, so I really have no idea how they really are. But I'm happy you like them. It's so sad when you buy pencils and you are all excited and all, and when they finally come and you test them and you just hate them. That is just so sad. So I'm so happy that you like them. Need a little bit. Well, I'm just pulling it from the tip, taking that little bit down there. that. I need some green for my leaves again. I'll just pull one up. There's some lovely colors, and I like the bat a bit hard when it's depending on the other. Oh, they are hard, yeah. Yeah, me too. Dancers, I do, but. And. The thing is that I usually hate new pencils anyways. Like when I got my announce, I only got some at the beginning. I think I started with 6 pencil to test out, and that was 1 white, and the white was amazing, and some skin tones, but so I had this white, and I think I had like 3 skin tones and 2 blues and 1 turquoise, I think, or something. And I really didn't get the fuss about them because they wasn't good at all. They felt sticky and they and very uneven. Because some was like this white was really soft and gave a lot of coverage, but some of those other colors was just sticky and they wasn't good, so I didn't like them, and I was so sad because I wanted to like them because so many other artists loves them, and so I wanted so hard to like them, but I really didn't. I actually kind of hated them, so I just put them away, and yeah. And then they was like hidden in a drawer for some months before I took them out and tested them again, and I liked the color. Good morning, Melissa. And as I used them, I actually learned to love them. So now I do. I think I want this one green just to break up all this pink and purple stuff, actually. So I will have those little piece-like stuff. Green. This is Hooker's green. Do I have a green that is more like an emerald? Let's see, I think that one maybe. I don't know, maybe this one, vivid green. Isn't that on the, as the darker areas? Now I lost something. I bought more t-shirts, said I had to go up. The delivery on the summer and see if the fucking was. Oh! This is out. But now waiting right country. I hope you get it soon then, more t-shirts. Dating for stuff is often horrible, and the time goes so slow too, so I surely hope that you will get it really fast. We have missed you too, Melissa. You have to come back really fast. When is your company leaving? Was it this weekend? And on Sunday, okay. Oh no, now my laptop is buffering. I hope you don't. And my phone looks okay. It just have a low battery, so I will have to put the battery charger in. Like that. I just hope that all is good there. Okay, good. Thank you, Charlotte. So, working my way up on this piece. Like that. So. So we got now a lot done. We got now all our leaves now. We got that little mice. Many mice. But we have only one. So and we have done all this part down here. This piece. The background here. The bad edge. Oh, we didn't wet that part. Ooh. That we have to do. Just taking away this extra water that came. Come on. Might have to use a pencil there because that is really tiny. And so we have done this pink stuff behind there and all of our leaves. So it's not that much left now. So I think that maybe in the next episode we can color rest of this stuff. And then we will do one dive only for skin because the skin takes a takes it. Time and I'm not doing that with the Inktense. Oh, your dog is sleeping in your arms or on it. Oh my god. Well, yeah, Melissa, I think so too because this one I'm working only on a camera. So, I don't know really, Sargot, when Mardell is coming back here. He said like in the next couple of days and that it will, that he would stick to 10 his time, that is 4 our time and will be 3 UK time, I think. So we'll just keep our eyes open and look for him, actually. He probably will announce it on either Facebook or Instagram. Oh, thank you, Susan. I'm so sorry that you are in a hospital, but I'm happy I have lifted your spirits. I'm happy that I can do that. Thank you so much, Susan, for coming and for your questions. Because when you wonder, then others wonder too. So somebody has to ask, and when you do it, I think that is wonderful. So thank you so much. So it looks like we have two more sessions with this one. The skin in one and the rest of this stuff, like this, the B and back around and shadings. Shading will take some time too. So I've been on for 1 hour and 45 minutes now. So I thank you all for coming. It's been a lot of fun. I'm so happy so many of you actually could come, even if it is really, really early, around half the world. So, and I don't know really when I will be back, because I just jump on whenever I can, like now my hubbit, okay, youngest, one out, so then I was like, oh my god, no. And I just jumped on. So thank you all for coming, and I'll see you later again, and around in the community. Thank you, Elizabeth, Frances, Melody, Darlene, and Susan, Lizzie, and Kim. Thank you all so much. Thank you, Charlotte. So, take care, and we'll see you again later. Thank you, Tisha, and I'll even learn, teach you how to say bye in Norwegian. Ha det!